Welcome back, guys. Sweet Chris here, and I'm bringing you the October 2024 installment of NetSuite News. Now, if you've watched some of my earlier NetSuite News videos, you know the basic structure. There's a few different subjects that I'll cover. The last couple months have been a little weird because there was Suite World, so I was mainly talking about that in the NetSuite News videos for August and September. But we're now into October, so we're back to the norm. And the first thing that I want to talk about this month is in relation to the recent NetSuite release. So this is the second release of the year. There's always two in any given year where the entire NetSuite system will update. And by the time this video releases, pretty much everybody should be through that release and basically on the updated version, which is 2024.2. So a few things I want to talk about in relation to that release and what's going to be included within it. And the first thing I want to bring up is in relation to the user interface. So there's been teased for a little while now that the interface for NetSuite was going to change. And this might seem like it's coming out of the blue to some degree, but if you're familiar with the Oracle products, they have a certain look to them and a certain UI for all of the Oracle products. And it's been the intention for some time to bring NetSuite over into that. Really, since Oracle's acquired NetSuite, it's been kind of getting morphed and changed to be more part of the family. So it's not kind of its own thing and its own company, but it's really just another product within the Oracle product family. So with this current release, you now have the ability to click a button and basically transition over to the Redwood UI. I'll actually come out with a video next week that specifically shows you how to do that. It'll highlight some features of Redwood. Also, right now, I'm gonna kind of pull up on the screen just a walkthrough of the system so you can get a little concept of what this looks like. As you'll see, it doesn't look wildly different. You shouldn't freak out and think that this is going to be completely different. I won't be able to find everything. First off, you don't need to actually even go onto Redwood at this moment in time. Maybe at some point in the future, you'll be forced to use the Redwood UI, but right now you have it off by default and you can turn it on if you want to. So you don't have to go onto it. If you do choose to, you'll see that all the same things are in the same places. The navigational paths are the same. It's really just a little bit of a different skin. And even then, it's not wildly different. In certain areas, like if you're on a specific record, like a sales order or a customer record. So there are little differences. All the buttons look a little different, the fields, things like that. But it's a minor change. A lot of people are going to be kind of playing around with this. You can check it out. At least try it and see what you feel about it. A lot of people that have been using NetSuite for years don't particularly like it because they're so used to the old system, but it does have a clean look. You know, I don't fault it for trying something new and having a little bit of a modern approach. And that is something that you can take advantage of right now. So that's the new Redwood user interface. The next thing I want to talk about in relation to the 2024.2 release is just in terms of features and apps and changes, there have been a few changes and additions made to suite billing and related to suite billing. So for example, they came out with a prepay feature that's usable with suite billing. They also came out with an integration ability between configure price quote, also known as CPQ, and with suite billing. So you're able to, for example, have subscription pay models attached to CPQ. So if you need that, that can be useful. These are not necessarily things you couldn't do before, but you needed a customization to be able to pull them off. So now they're just usable off the shelf. They have features that come native with NetSuite. There's also just an improvement to the bill capture. If you're not familiar with that, I've talked about it in a few other videos. It's using AI. They basically scan a bill that comes in. So if you get a bill from a vendor, it'll scan through, it'll recognize fields, and it will generate a new bill, populating the information based on the scan. So this is one of the few new NetSuite AI releases that I really have nothing bad to say about it. I think it's a great idea. The software works quite well and they're continuing to make improvements to it. But even just in general, it does a great job. And as long as the invoice or the bill that you're getting is not crazy in its formatting and has fields that have odd names, it does a great job of figuring out what fields go where. So I highly recommend, if you haven't used it already, that you at least check it out. It's quite interesting to just kind of see how it figures out and scans through a bill. So that's the suite billing side of things. They're also making changes and enhancements in areas like inventory management, Ship Central, Suite People. What all of these things have in common is they're areas that NetSuite is not natively very strong at. They're areas where other third-party apps and products such as RF Smart tend to be superior and tend to get looked at first over some of the native NetSuite products such as WMS. So these are areas where it looks like they're trying to shore up some of their weaknesses and improve things that they know they don't have up to par with some of the competition. So none of the changes are particularly groundbreaking, but they do look like they're trying to add functionality and trying to improve features in these areas. So that's the NetSuite release for the second part of the year. The next thing I want to talk about is specifically in relation to some of the super training courses that we have since Suite World. In the last 4 weeks, I've actually come out with 3 new products. It's been a crazy month. So I want to talk about those, and really specifically 2 of them that I wanted to mention. The first being a corporate training package that I just released. And this includes, up until now, I've had individual courses, and you can also get packages of courses, but for one person. So these corporate training packages are now available where your entire team can take advantage of it for all users for all courses. So this is something, just because I was getting so many requests from people working for a company that wanted it for themselves and for their coworkers, we now have this as an option so you can have the entire team, especially if you're going through an implementation, you can utilize that for something like user acceptance testing. It also comes with additional features like email support with myself. So if you have questions or issues you're running into, you can always reach out to me. Anyone who's already emailed me, I get emails a lot. You know that I answer emails very quickly and I'm always happy to help students and anyone signing up. So please take advantage of that. The second product that we just came out with is a NetSuite implementation guide. So that guide is going to be close to 30 minutes long and basically lays out the timeline that you can expect of your implementation, as well as some tips and tricks on greatly increasing the likelihood of having a successful implementation. I deliberately kept it free because I wanted it to be broadly accessible and have as many people have a painless implementation as humanly possible. So if you're interested in that for either your company or someone you know, please, the link will be down below as well as up above, and you can take advantage of that. Moving on from the super training content, I did want to comment on career paths because I know a lot of the people that watch this channel are looking for work in the NetSuite world. And while I was at Suite World, I met a number of different people as well as talked to a lot of consulting companies in the NetSuite space. One in particular that I thought was interesting was I spoke at length with a representative from Bryant Park Consulting, and they have a training program that's 12 weeks long that takes someone from absolutely no knowledge of NetSuite up to the point of having your full certifications and at least having shadowed and worked with other consultants and ready to start as a junior consultant working on implementations. So it's kind of like a 12-week crash course mix of theory, practicals, shadowing, passing examinations, and getting up to the point of hitting that junior consultant status. There is, of course, Oracle NetSuite has their own training program, but I found this one interesting in the way that they mix things up, as well as how condensed the timeline is and how much they can get you through in such a short amount of time. So by all means, I will have the link down below. You can check that out and see if Bryant Park Consulting would be a correct career path for you. Moving on from that, we have the app of the month. If you watched some of my earlier videos, you'll know I had a video recently on Power BI as an integration with NetSuite. So I am going to be highlighting that in this month's video, specifically because NetSuite, again, is not particularly known for its visual reporting. I've said that in many other videos. And what's great about the Power BI integration, which is using Microsoft's Power BI tool and connecting that in with NetSuite, is with a little bit of customization and working with a consulting team on that, you can create a dashboard of reporting tools that are highly visual with bar charts, line plots, different analyses of, you know, profit margins, things like that. You can have all of this custom built for not that much money, especially for mid-sized businesses or larger. You can have something that's very impressive and useful as a management reporting tool for as little as $5,000 or $7,000, something really high quality. So as I'm talking, I've obviously having a visual on screen, kind of walking through what some of these things look like, showing just one example of a custom made dashboard specifically using Power BI. You can also use a number of other business intelligence tools. There's at least a dozen or so that are highly competitive, but Power BI is the most known and tends to be the one most implemented because the consultants are then most familiar with it. So that's the app of the month. And that concludes this version of NetSuite News for the month of October 2024. If you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And of course, check out any of the links below if either the Super Training courses, Bryant Park Consulting, Power BI, any of these things are of particular interest to you. And with that, I'll see you in the next video.